I'm currently in the hotel NH Amistad, the NH Amistad in Cordoba. Already an interesting place to stay, so let's check out the room and then I'll show you the obstacles it took for me to get to my room. It's very nice, actually, bright. It's got a hint of smoke in the air. Bright bathroom. This is for important people because got her own telephone by the commode.
So like I mentioned before, here is obstacle number one, lifting my luggage up these 5 steps from the door to check in. After check-in, you now have to carry your luggage down the 5 steps to get to the elevator. I was told my room was 207, got that 207. So from the elevator, your selection is third floor to get to 207. Exiting the elevator, I locate my sign. Okay, 207 this direction. Now I have to go down this ramp with my now 60-pound plus Samsonite on wheels, which is gaining momentum for the purpose of crashing through this door. But all is well once you step foot into this glorious city of Cordoba. Cordoba has a rich history. Starting with the medieval times, it was a Visigoth fortress. In 206 BC, the Romans built their major highway from Cadiz to Rome through Cordoba. And ultimately, this city became the capital of the Islamic Caliphate, which was in 716. And during this time, the city flourished. In fact, by the end of the 11th century, it was the most populated city in the world and was considered the intellectual center of Europe. During this time, Cordoba had 3,000 mosques and the largest library in the world. I was very impressed with the gardens outside of the Alcazar. The Alcazar is an Arab word for palace, and it has a lot of history. In the year 1236, the Christian forces took Cordoba, and in 1482, the Alcazar became the headquarters for the Inquisition and used it for torture and interrogation chambers. And they did this for 3 centuries to follow. Here's some other historical notes about the Alcazar. In 1492, Christopher Columbus was received here. In 1810, Napoleon Bonaparte used it as a garrison, and in 1821, it became a prison. It wasn't until 1950 that it became a national monument. On the grounds of the Alcazar is one of the remaining mosques that was, you know, although I'm Catholic, it was sad to see how the Christians built a cathedral right in the center of this mosque, which is beautiful. I learned that when the Moors and the Muslims build their mosques, they believe there should be no depictions of animals or human images. But if you look at the Christian side of the cathedral, you'll see the very ornate images and sculptures, almost in spite of what the Muslims had built. This mosque, which was built in the 8th century, is called the Mesquita. During a time when Christians and Muslims and Jews all coexisted, during a time which was considered to be Cordoba's and Spain's golden age. In most hotels here, I think it's a great idea. I have not seen this in the United States yet.
but it's for the purpose of energy conservation. There's a slot by every door entrance in the hotels. When you walk in, you put your key card inside the slot and it activates all the electricity in the room. So if you fail to do that, none of the lights will turn on. Your key card is there when it's time to walk out. Obviously, you need your key card to get back in. So you'll take that card out of the slot, which in turn turns off all the electricity while you're gone. So it's a great idea.